Ouais.
Alara. Doctor.
Yes. Okay, as soon as I'm done.
They were born by cesarean 3 months ago. An addition from West Germany called me this morning.
Occipital craniopagus twins have never both survived a separation.
Yeah, he knows that.
If they're not separated, they'll spend the rest of their lives in bed on their backs. The hospital wants me to fly to Germany and examine them.
Ben, are you gonna do this?
Nobody's ever done it. In situations like this, one baby always dies.
Welcome to Germany. We've been anxiously awaiting your arrival, Dr. Carson. Allow me to introduce Peter and Augusta Rausch.
Grüß Gott.
Thank you for coming.
How do you do, Doctor?
My pleasure.
And this is Johann and Stefan.
I wanted to kill myself when I learned the truth. But I realized I would be killing two other beings too. And then as soon as I saw them, my heart melted.
Please, don't ask us to choose between them.
Well, they don't appear to be sharing any organs, which is good. There are parts of the brain, such as the vision center, that aren't completely separated. We won't know until we get in there.
How soon can that be?
Well, first we have to solve the problem of exsanguination. It never succeeded. You see, babies have very little blood. And unless I can figure out a way to keep them from bleeding out, I can't risk performing this operation. I'll do it.
Good.
Make it two. Make it four.
Still haven't figured out how to save them both, huh?
I'm working on it.
Back to your neighbor.
25.
That's excellent, Kathy. Mark?
30.
Good for you, Mark. You got them all right. Benjamin. Benjamin. How many did you get right?
Nine?
Why, Benjamin, that's wonderful. I'm so proud of you.
Not nine, Miss Williamson. He got
None. You'd think he'd get at least one right.
He got one right last. You're the dumbest kid in the class. But did you hear what they said on Cronkite last night on the news? You're the dumbest kid in the world.
Danny, how could this have been an accident?
Well, it was almost an accident. I never would have hit him if I remembered I had to lock my hand.
The boy had 5 stitches and his parents are very upset. I'm not sure how to discipline your son, Mrs. Carson.
I'll handle it.
I'm also very concerned about his grades. Have you seen his latest report card?
So what happened? You weren't getting great. You weren't meant to be a failure, Bennett. And you can control your temper, but and you can bring your grades up, too. I know you can.
I'm dumb, Mother.
No, you ain't. You a smart boy. Listen to me. Listen to me. You just ain't using that smartness. Now, if you keep getting grades like that, you're going to spend the rest of your life mopping floors in a factory, and that ain't the life I want for you. That ain't the life God wants for you, either.
Yes, Mother.
I'm gonna have to have a talk with him about you and your brother, Curtis.
Oh, no, no. He invited us to the game tonight, remember? Why don't you and I go? Get me Candlestick Park, please.
As I said, they would. You finish your homework?
Most of it.
Why didn't Benny, you put my room with your eyes sitting too close to this TV. You do your homework?
I need help.
Curtis, help your brother.
I gotta finish my math.
Mother, I need help.
What she need help with?
Just history, and I don't really understand it.
Well, what don't you understand?
Like, all the words. Could you read this for me?
I need new reading glasses. Why don't you tell me what it's about? Some of them?
Self,
look at me. Can you tell me what them cereal boxes is on the shelf?
Sure.
I mean, can you read them?
Not this far, can you?
Sarah, happy. Benny, congratulations. You're doing much better.
Yes.
Well, it's an improvement, all right. And I'm proud of you for not getting an F. You a smart boy. But you both can do better.
Doing the best I can, Mother.
How? I don't know how.
Well, I don't know how. We just gonna have to use our imagination.
I don't got one.
Of course you do. Everybody got an imagination.
Not me.
Of course you do. Listen to me. If I...
Oh.
Benny.
Mother, my brain's too dumb.
Boy, your brain ain't dumb.
It is, Mom.
You got all the world in here. You just got to see beyond what you can see.
What is this, a race of some kind?
Betty, slow down.
You act as though this were your last meal.
We've got to write your contest essay tonight, Father.
Oh, well, in that case, maybe you had better hurry. Look, don't choke.
I'll get it.
I never saw it to fail. Every time we sit down to eat, the phone rings.
I know how to stop it, Dad.
He wants me to come up to his uncle's farm this weekend. Isn't that great?
Well, how are you going
to
get there?
Ooh, Joe's got a license. We could drive.
The last time he took a trip, he wrecked his dad's car. Whose car is he figuring on wrecking this time?
Yours. He thought.
I know what he thought. But I wouldn't trust Joe Phillips with a pogo stick.
Yours. Please, Dad, I'll be careful.
How can you be careful if he's driving?
You let me do anything.
I'm not going to let you do this.
You think I was a juvenile or something?
When you act this way, you are. Now eat your dinner.
I'm not hungry.
Then excuse yourself.
Mother, come on, we'll be late for church.
You're going ahead without me, honey. Mama's having one of her days.
Well, the missionary doctor and his wife, who were surprised by bandits. You see, these thieves were terrible men. Bloodthirsty, huh? Vicious. They not only robbed their victims, they slit their throats and laughed as they watched them die. Y'all don't hear me. This poor doctor and his wife ran for their lives as the thieves chased them across rocky, barren land. Oh, these missionaries' feet were cut open by sharp stones. Their clothes were torn by brambles. And finally, they came up. The doctor ran up to the front door of the fortress and tried to open it, but it was locked. Oh, if only someone would let them in. No one was there. The doctor and his wife hid, but the bandit king saw them and drew his sword. There appeared to be nothing that could save God's good people.
The bandit king was after me, and so I hit him with some straw, and a blue mouse came out and scared his horse, and I got away. I saw it in my brain.
That's good.
That's all imagination, dummy.
Shut up.
Watch your mouth, Curtis.
Mother, I want to be a doctor. A missionary doctor, just like the one Pastor Ford told us about.
You can be anything you want to be in this life, long as you're willing to work at it. And that goes for you too, Curtis. God will not abandon you. Excuse me. Need to talk to someone.
Me, ma'am. Let's see if we can help you. All right.
I spent my childhood in foster care. When my husband, Mr. Carson, married me, he was my ticket out of there.
How old were you?
13. Oh, we were happy. We had a lovely home, two beautiful boys.
Then what?
I don't like to talk about it. He had another wife and kids. When I found out, my life fell apart.
When was this, Mrs. Carson?
5 years back. But I couldn't leave my husband because my boys needed their daddy and I didn't know how I'd make it on my own.
Are you still together?
No. I found out he was dealing drugs, so me and the boys moved to Boston. I got his sister there.
Why'd you come back to Detroit?
I got the house and the divorce, and I kept it. And me and my boys gonna move back in.
How do you support yourself?
I clean houses and I babysit. That's about all I can do. Nobody knows this. I'm so dumb. I can't even read. And I feel
and my boys are gonna turn out the same way. And nothing's gonna work out. But lately, I can't stop them. I even think about killing myself.
Mrs. Carson, what would you say to checking yourself in with us?
Oh, no.
Just for a little while.
I can't afford to do anything like
that. Don't think about the money. We'll find the money.
Boys, I'm gonna be going away for a little while.
What? What do you mean?
Where?
Just for a few weeks. I'm going back to Boston to see Aunt Jean Avery.
Can we come with you?
No. You got school. You got homework.
So you're just gonna leave us alone?
Of course not. Sister Scott gonna come and stay with you. In the meantime, I want you boys to do me a favor. I want you both to learn your times tables while I'm gone.
What?
No way.
You can do it.
Do you know how many there are? That could take a year.
Don't take my boys.
But it's hard work.
Well, hard work ain't never hurt nobody. Besides, you ain't going outside to play till you learn them tables.
Wait, Mother, please, no. Come on, that's not fair.
Oh, Mother, you're the meanest man in the world.
Last one's 4.
30.
No.
31.
This isn't a guessing game, Benny.
Benny, listen to your brother.
Mark?
25.
I didn't cheat.
I didn't say you did. What's your score?
24 out of 25.
Sister Scott! Sister Scott! I got an A! I got an A! Sister Scott! Sister Scott! I got... Mother!
I missed you. I missed you.
Oh, I missed you too.
I know all my timetables. I got them all right, except for one.
Let me see. I knew you could do it. I knew you could. Professor Burkett, I'm Mrs. Carson, your new cleaning woman.
It's the kitchen floor.
What about it?
It sparkles.
Well, your last cleaning lady didn't do a very good job, but I do the best I can.
The last cleaning lady was me. My late wife was very sick. I took care of her and not much else.
I'm sorry.
Thank you.
Sir, did you read all these books?
Most of them. Why?
They can stay with Corporal Dolan's family at Salt River until Barker's gone.
Yes, sir.
Come to think of it, you better stay there yourself.
Yes, sir.
Hey, what'd you do?
What's going on? I was watching that.
You boys watch too much television.
Not more than anybody else.
Don't worry about everybody else. This whole world is full to everybody else. From now on, you're gonna pick two pre-selected programs per week.
A week?
You're crazy. I mean, this is crazy.
And that's after you finish your homework.
What are we gonna do with all our free time?
I'm glad you asked. You're gonna go to the library and pick out two books. And at the end of the week, you're gonna hand me a written report about what you read.
Two books?
I don't believe what you're saying. We cannot possibly survive it on television.
Well, you're gonna stop. It'd be long before folks was watching you on TV.
Mama said there'll be days like this, there'll be days like this, Mama said.
Mama said.
Man, there's a lot of books in here.
Shut up, boys. Library.
Hearing the great roar made the young man wonder if he had chosen wisely. Maybe it was a trick. Was there really a tiger, or just a recording of a tiger's roar?
Maybe there was a tiger behind the other door, and he died like all the other princes before him.
That's good, Benny. That's real good. I need to get new reading glasses. Sign it out.
Ag. Ag.
Agriculture. A-G-R-I-C-U-L-T-U-R-E. Agriculture.
Excellent, Benjamin. Kathy, combine.
Combine. C-O-M-B-I-N-E. Combine.
The 20-point bonus appears your toss-up. You know, several limericks begin, "There was a young lady from Perth." Limerick is in Ireland. For 10 points, where is Perth?
Australia.
Wow. Australia, Scotland.
Well, how could they know so much?
Right for 10 points.
Don't know much about history. Don't know much biology.
Vinny, come on, we're gonna be late.
Don't know much about the French I took. But I do know that I love you. And I know that if you love me too, what a wonderful world this would be.
Excuse me. Do you have any books on rocks?
Don't know much trigonometry. Don't know much about algebra. Don't know what a star.
Okay, class. What about this? Anybody? Yes. Benjamin. Can you identify this rock?
It's obsidian.
Obsidian? That's right. Do you know how it was made?
Well, it was formed after a volcanic eruption by the supercooling of the lava when it hits the water. The volcano erupts and the lava flows down red hot. And so when it hits the water, the elements coalesce and it becomes hard. And that makes obsidian. I mean, obsidian, sorry.
I see you after class. What happened?
I'm sorry.
What are you sorry for? Someone unlocked the door. Look at this. You just stepped into a whole other world.
Magnitude. M-A-G-N-I-T-U-D-E. Magnitude.
Mark? Perpetuate.
Perpetuate.
The feast of unleavened.
Benny, are you in there?
What potion had a sort of mixed flavor of cherry tart, custard, pineapple,
Alice in Wonderland?
The potion which Alice in Wonderland drank, which made her grow into various sizes.
Tell me, when Cain settled down east of Eden, in what land did he live?
In the land of Nod.
Right, for 10 points. How many tales in the Canterbury Tales?
24.
Right. Yes. 20-point bonus. A 20-point bonus coming up. Here's your toss-up. A leading Major League Baseball player and the layer of the earth between...
Mantle. Rutgers, Mickey Mantle.
Right, between the crust and the core have the same name. What is it? Yeah. Wow, you're there before I have the...
U-N-T-E-R. Saunter.
Lacquer.
Lacquer. L-A-C-K-E-R. Lacquer.
Sorry, Cliff. Benjamin, if you spell it correctly, you win.
Lacquer. L-A-C-Q-U-E-R. Lacquer.
That is correct.
Yes!
The certificate for the student with the highest academic achievement in the eighth grade goes to Benjamin Carson.
Before Benjamin takes a seat, I have a few words I want to say. Benjamin is a boy of color. He has no father in his life. He comes to us with tremendous disadvantages. There's no reason you shouldn't have done better than him. What's wrong with you kids? You're not trying hard enough. You should be ashamed.
The certificate for outstanding citizenship goes to Alexa Courtney.
Right, for 10 points. All right, here's a 20-point bonus, Brandeis. Identify the composer.
Vivaldi.
That's right, for 10 points. This picture by Monet would be classified as French impression. That's right.
I'll turn it down.
No, I like it. Turn it up.
Won't Mrs. Graham knock on the ceiling again?
Let her knock. We moving.
We're moving?
Enough money take back that house we've been renting out. So start next fall, you going to a school that appreciates you.
So old and so ugly, even the winos didn't want them. What? I gave them the new blood over there.
Do you have any money left?
What you mean?
Any clothes for school?
You got clothes for school.
Old clothes.
Good clothes.
Not good enough for Hunter High.
I seen the clothes them kids wear. The cheap.
No, they're not.
I didn't say they weren't expensive. I said the cheap. And most folks that wear cheap clothes on the outside are dead on the inside. Folks I work for, they buy clothes at last. That's what I try to get you. Take Professor Burkett. I wash his clothes. Ew!
Hey, Carl, you should use Carson's shirt in class as a chemistry lesson.
A chemistry lesson?
Yeah, because it smells so bad, it killed all the bugs that was breeding inside of it.
They was breeding because your mama wore it.
I think you're confusing that with your mama. Your clothes are so raggedy, even the mummy turned them down.
Your mama's so old, she's the mummy's mama.
Yeah, well, your mama's so old, your daddy's a dinosaur.
Your mama's so old, her birth certificate says expired on it.
You got clothes for school.
Not good enough for Hunter High.
Come on. Jerome.
Morning.
Morning.
Why aren't you wearing the pants I got you? Don't they fit?
No. I didn't try them on.
Why not?
They're the wrong kind.
What you mean they're the wrong kind? I paid good money for them pants.
That's too bad. You can take them back if you want.
I can't take them back. I bought them on special.
That's too bad, but I'm not gonna wear them.
I'm fixing this window myself, Bennett, so I'd have money to get you them pants.
That's your problem.
Down this path, talking smart and acting stupid. Why, if I didn't know
me, shut up! All you do is push me, shut up!
You can buy whatever you want. You pay the bills. You pay the bills next month. I'll bring home every dime I make in cash and hand it to you. And what you got left, you keep for yourself.
Now you're talking.
Hey, B. What's this crap?
It's not crap, all right?
Shut up. You like this? You call this music?
It's better than what you like. Hey, man, quit proving how stupid you are. You don't have to act so ignorant.
Go to hell, man.
What'd you say to me?
Get off!
Thank you.
Lord, you have to take this temper away from me. Please, please, just take it.
Jesus, it's all the world to me. My life, my joy, my all. He is my strength from day to day. Without him, I would fall. When I am sad.
Protesters are here in Central Park, 50,000 strong, and there has been a significant shooting.
It is, in my opinion, the most amazing organ the human body holds. By stimulating one section of the brain of an 85-year-old, you can bring back, verbatim, memories of a newspaper article read 60 years before. Consider your own brains. They've absorbed and digested enough information to bring you here, which is no small achievement. Your dreams are all possible because of 3 pounds of us, which is why I've devoted my life, as a surgeon, to probing its mysteries.
How did you do that?
A lot of time away from home, my wife would tell you. But dedication and intelligence are the easy part. You also need an incredible hand-eye coordination, which is a gift.
A brain surgeon, my goodness. Well, I always said you can do anything anybody else can do, Benny. Only you can do it better. Don't laugh at me, it's true.
Your grades are good.
They're fine.
Now tell me, how's that girlfriend of yours?
My mother says hi.
Oh, can't wait to meet her. You think she's coming for Parents Weekend?
Not if I'm not here.
What? What are you talking about?
Candy, you're a triple major. I'm having trouble with just one.
Trouble?
Yells too much for me. What am I doing here anyway?
You got a scholarship. You were third in your class.
Yeah, and everybody else here graduated first. My grades are lousy, especially chemistry. If I don't pass this final exam, I lose my scholarship, which means I can't be the doctor,
whoa,
which is the
whoa.
Only thing
slow down. What do you...
I don't know. Reading. I'm good at reading. If all I ever did was read, I'd be just fine. Instead, I gotta sit through all these boring lectures 8 hours a day.
Skip the lectures. The professors don't care.
That'll only make things worse.
They can't be any worse than they are now. Hey, what do I know? Maybe I'm just...
No. Oh, you're right. Thank you.
You're welcome. Joseph Lister.
Pioneered the compound microscope and made surgeons wear clean gloves on an object equals the time change of rate of its momentum. Formula for methane.
No.
Propane.
No.
Finish them. You don't need to book. You got the book. Inside you.
Open your test booklets and begin.
Be a neurosurgeon, you should marry me because I probably won't be home much.
Is that a promise?
Johns Hopkins accepts only 2 students a year for neurosurgery residency. This year we have 125 applicants. So, why would she take you?
I have good grades and excellent recommendations.
As do all of our applicants.
Johns Hopkins is my first choice. It's my only choice.
You have confidence. Yes. Why did you decide to become a brain doctor?
The brain. It's a miracle. Do you believe in miracles? Not a lot of doctors do. There's not a lot of faith among physicians. We study reports, cut open bodies. It's all very tangible, solid. But the fact is, there's still so many things we just can't explain. I believe we're all capable of performing miracles. Skills. Look at Handel. I mean, how can he compose something like the Messiah in only 3 weeks? This is the channel, the source, the inspiration for unbelievable accomplishments.
You like classical music?
I love it.
I do too. I think we'll get on quite well together.
Morning.
Morning.
You're late. Mr. Schwartz in 301 needs to be taken to surgery now.
Oh, no, I'm not an orderly. I'm the new intern.
Oh, report to Dr. Farmington for rounds.
Dr. McCall, please call 2488.
This young man has a disease called von Hippel-Lindau. It's very rare and causes multiple tumors throughout the brain. He has his second surgery tomorrow, and it will most likely cripple him. Carson, draw some blood. Hear what you think, you do as I say. Don't think you're special, Carson, simply because there's no one like you in this department. You don't change your attitude, I'd get you kicked out of neurosurgery faster than you say yassa.
Are you finished?
Yes.
Fine.
Thank you.
How was it?
Baseball bat is deteriorating rapidly.
Please tell him that all the neurosurgeons at Hopkins are away at a conference. I am a resident. It is illegal for me to operate without an attending physician present.
I can't reach Dr. Farmington. And I can't reach Dr. Udvar-Hai.
If someone doesn't operate on this man soon, he will die. Do a lobectomy. Mine will be done, Lord. Amen. Scalpel. Foley. Bipolar.
Dr. Udvar-Hai wants to see you in his office ASAP.
You operated on this man without permission, without supervision. You put this hospital in serious legal jeopardy. Had this man died,
you did very well, Dr. Carson. I congratulate you on taking the proper action in spite of its possible consequences.
Okay, come on. Move, move. She's seizing. Watch your seat, too.
Okay. We're here.
Okay.
Okay, so we're here.
Give you something to make you better.
I don't matinee to me.
All right. It's getting worse, Doctor.
Okay,
we're here. Barry, have a look at this. The patient's a four-year-old by the name of Cynthia Gonzalez. She's been having seizures since she was 18 months. She now has about 100 a day. They only affect her right side. She's been diagnosed with Rasmussen's. Her parents have been told there's nothing to be done.
It's the only time she's seizure-free. She's awake. She lives between convulsions. She's been on 35 different medications over the years. Sometimes they're so strong she doesn't recognize me.
She's beautiful.
One doctor called her a mentally retarded epileptic.
Well, I'm here to tell. The left side of Cynthia's brain is like a troubled kid on a playground beating up on her own twin. Now you control that kid and the playground's at peace.
How do we do that?
There's an operation called a hemispherectomy. It involves removing the seizure-prone part of the brain.
What?
How will she be able to live or survive with half a brain?
It's not as bad as it sounds. We don't know why, but a child's brain has a remarkable ability to recover. It's as if the brain cells haven't decided what they want to be when they grow up. They take on the...
There's a chance this will work?
Yes, I do. But it is a gamble. There's no way around that. If Cynthia survives, she could be paralyzed on her right side. The left side of the brain controls the speech area. She may lose her ability to speak.
Have you done one of these operations yourself?
No, I have not.
Wishing it were 4 months from now.
Why, so we can get less sleep than we do now?
Your mother called today. She said the movies are coming in a week. She's so excited.
Me too.
So are you ready?
For my mother or two more babies?
For tomorrow.
Scalpel.
Removing the skull to access the We need to reduce the swelling. Inserting to relieve fluid pressure. I've removed the entire left hemisphere of the brain.
Cynthia, can you hear me? Can you open your eyes, sweetheart? We're all done. Let's see those pretty eyes, sweetheart. Come on. It's time to wake up, Cynthia. Let's see those now. I don't know why she's not waking up, Ben.
Twice as long as we thought. She lost 9 pints of blood, just double her normal volume. But she came through just fine. Though it might be a while before we know if she can move or speak.
Mommy. Daddy. I love you.
She talks, she hears, she thinks, she responds. There are no additional signs of weakness.
Dr. President, how is this possible?
Brain's a miraculous organ.
What about you? How long have you been practicing?
I completed my residency 3 years ago, but I haven't yet taken my oral exam.
Are there any more seizures, Doctor?
So far, the seizures have subsided.
You're gonna love it here. Ben. Ben, honey, wake up. Wake up. I gotta go to the hospital. I gotta go to the hospital.
Oh, no.
Get ready to cross-match the field. Do you feel any contractions? Okay, ma'am, this might feel tight around your arm. Let me take your blood pressure.
Okay, hook up the fetal monitor.
This is just some oxygen to help you breathe. Here you go, Mrs. Carson.
Everything okay?
She'll be fine, Dr. Carson. She'll be just fine. I'm so sorry.
There's nothing I could do.
What time is it?
11:30.
You be on duty. Your patients need you.
You need me.
I have you. Go to work.
Okay, thank you. Oh, doctor, where have you been? You're late. What happened? I've been calling your house all morning.
I'll make up for it. Very good, very nice. Help me, Lord.
Ben, I've just been told you want to hold off the operation on the twins. The sooner we operate, the better the chances for recovery.
I know, but they'll bleed out. I can't figure out a way around that.
Look, you're the best pediatric neurosurgeon in the world.
You may think I'm the best.
That's why they chose you.
Kitchen doing dishes after dinner.
Except in Detroit, we didn't have a dishwasher.
Well, yes, we did. You looking at her. So proud of her. You still think about them Siamese twins, don't you?
Sometimes I feel like, I don't know, Mother. Like a faucet that's all dried up.
I felt that way plenty of times. Thing is, you got to find out what's blocking it and move that thing out the way.
I don't know what's blocking it.
Sure you do. But even if you fail, at least you did something. Oh, Benny. You can do this. Sure you can. You got all the world in here. You just gotta see beyond what you can see. Yes, come on. Yeah.
Mark? Where go? First off, we'll need to have the room wired with emergency power in case there's an electrical failure. Then we'll need two of everything, two anesthesia monitors, two heart-lung machines, enough people on each team to cover both babies. We'll need an anesthesiology team, a team of cardiac surgeons, a team of plastic surgeons, a team of neurosurgeons, and we'll need to figure out how to fit all 50 of us into one operating room. Each team must rehearse their respective procedures step by step, and each team must develop scenarios for the worst possible things that could happen. If one baby dies, we need to separate him as fast as possible at 6 a.m.
Mom, Dad,
hello again, Peter, Augusta. Welcome to Johns Hopkins. Your son's blood vessels are like tiny faucets with only so much blood to lose. Now, if we can turn off the faucets, we can keep your sons from bleeding. The only way to do this is to stop their hearts.
Stop them.
It's not a new procedure. It's been used by cardiovascular surgeons for years. It's just never been applied in a situation like this. Now, we can do it in infants for an hour without causing brain damage, then spend that hour reconstructing all the blood vessels so that when their hearts start again, there won't be any life-threatening loss of blood.
All in for an hour?
Which is why we've rehearsed and rehearsed, and why we need to pray.
You pray, Doctor?
Every day.
pericardium to be used later as vascular tissue. Cardio is done. All yours, Ben.
My light, please. Scalpel.
I've opened the door and revealed the venous sinus that they share. I'm going to start separation now, starting below the torque. There's a lot of bleeding. Close it up. We'll try a different area.
Vital signs are stable.
Blood, it's huge.
Stitch.
We have to start hypothermic arrest.
Ben, we can't stop the hearts right now. We haven't finished separating all the veins. If we do it now, it'll cut too deeply into our hour.
If we don't stop the hearts, they'll bleed out.
Start cooling the blood.
Cooling. Prepare to inject the saline coolant solution to replace the blood.
Aortic cross clamp.
Blood cooling to 20 degrees.
The hearts are stopped. Turn off the heart-lung machine.
Okay, we have 1 hour to finish separation, rebuild the separate veins, and reconstruct the torcula.
Pick up.
Bipolar. More suction, please.
Dr. Wong, call the page operator.
I'm now separating the sagittal sinus. On my mark, 3, 2, 1, separate. Slowly.
Easy.
Get ready with the drapes. Make sure we don't contaminate the field.
Go ahead, hang it.
Adjust that light, please.
Got the drapes.
Yeah,
that's
set up.
More drapes from here. Adjust the drapes.
Just
straight. Anesthesia, how does it look? Give us a... Start the restructuring of the torcula. This is taking 3 times as long as I thought. It's just too darn small.
Pressure's coming down, Ben.
Done with vascular reconstruction.
Turn on the pump.
Yes, doctor.
Start rewarming the blood.
Yes, doctor. Warming the blood.
I don't think I can do it in time.
1 minute, 30 seconds, doctor.
You don't need the book. You got the book inside you.
Warm the blood.
Starting the pumps.
Get ready to start the heart, baby one.
Paddles in, baby two.
Clear, baby one. Okay, do it.
Baby two, charge to 10.
Clear. All right, do it.
Looks like sinus rhythm.
Start closing up the chest.
Closing.
Begin closing the dura. Dr. Long.
Closing, Ben.
Stitch, please.
Stitch, please.
Someone let the parents know we're almost finished.
Yes, doctor.
Close them up. Dr. Long.
One more stitch, Ben.
Disconnect my light, please.
Light, please.
Neuros.
Steps up to the podium.
I always said you can do anything anyone else can do.
Only you can do it better. It goes for you too, Mother. We love you.
I love you.
সুপ্রিম জানোয়ার এসে আমাকে ভয় দেখালো আর তোমরা এখানে আমার কিডন্যাপ করছো, এগুলো কি হচ্ছে?
আমার পেলেন্টা যদি আজকে বেচতে যায় তোকে আমি ছাড়ব না। ও শিট, আর কোথায় আমি খুঁজি?
ম্যাডাম আপনি চিন্তাই করবেন না।
দেখি কোথায় যাও।
লন্ডন জার্মান থেকে হেলিকপ্টার এসে আমাকে উড়িয়ে নিয়ে যাক, কি বলেন? ওকে।